अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ मोहम्मद हमजा एंड टॉपिक फॉर माय प्रोजेक्ट इज़ हिस्ट्री ऑफ जी टी रोड। द जी टी रोड फुल फॉर्म इज़ ग्रैंड ट्रंक रोड। इट वॉज ऑल्सो फॉर्मली नोन एज शराए आज़म और सड़क आज़म। इट इज़ वन ऑफ द साउथ एशिया ओल्डेस्ट एंड लॉन्गेस्ट मेजर रोड। फॉर सेवरल सेंचुरी इट हैज़ लिंक द वेस्टर्न एंड ईस्टर्न रीजन ऑफ इंडियन सब कॉन्टीनेंट, रनिंग फ्राम बांग्लादेश अक्रॉस नॉर्थ इंडिया इन टू पेशावर इन पाकिस्तान अप टू काबुल अफगानिस्तान। इट वॉज इनिशिएटेड एंड एक्सटेंडेड इन 14th century। द फर्स्ट नेम गिवन टू द जी टी रोड वॉज सड़क आज़म। इट वॉज कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन मुगल सेरा। लेटेस्ट ब्रिटिश रूलर गेव इट द नेम ऑफ ग्रैंड ट्रंक रोड। टूडे इट इज़ नोन एज द सेम नेम विच वॉज गिवन टू इट बाई ब्रिटिश इन द 16th century। A major road running across the Gangetic Plain was built afresh by Pashtun Emperor Sher Shah Suri, who then ruled over most of the northern India. His intention was to link together the remote provinces of his vast empire for administrative and military reasons. The Sarkiyazam, as it was then known, is universally recognized as having been the precursor of the Grand Trunk Road. The capital city was built on GT Road as well. It was then transformed into a latest highway of all lands. This road connects it with the Lahore, the ex-capital of Mughals. There are many parts of GT Road which are unchanged yet. Taxula, it's the living example of it, where you can observe the old road without any change. Few towers and minarets were made on the GT Road to indicate the distance and intervals. Few of them are still there and attest the glory of the Mughal Empire. Today, the Grand Trunk Road remains a continuum that covers a distance of over 3,700 kilometers from its origin at Chittagong. It transverses to Sonargaon in the district of Central Bangladesh. It then reaches India, passing through Kolkata, Durgapur, Dhanbad, Aurangabad, Allahabad, Kanpur, Agra, and Delhi. From there, the stretch between Delhi and Kolkata is known as National Highway 2. And there between Delhi and Wagha at the border with Pakistan is known as National Highway 1. Pakistan border, the Grand Trunk Road continues north through Lahore, Gujranwala, Gujarat, Jhelum, Rawalpindi, Nowshera, and Peshawar. It then enters Afghanistan and continues west through Jalalabad, Sarabi, and ends at Kabul. A large part of Afghan leg of Grand Trunk Road is today part of Jalalabad Kabul Road. Here you can see a map of GT Road. It passes from Chittagong, then it passes from India and its many cities like New Delhi, Haryana, Ludhiana, and Punjab. Then its road starts from Pakistan. It passes through Lahore, Faisalabad, Islamabad, and Jammu and Kashmir. And Pakistan, then it takes its road to Peshawar, the city of Kabul, and Jalalabad in its road center. Babur, the first Mughal king, got the credit to build it in the year 1520. It was built on those ways which were followed by many legends and warriors of the history like Genghis Khan and Alexander the Great. After 26 kilometers, 2,000 stone cutters were used in its construction. The GT Road contained many small and big bridges on its way. 6 horses cleaning were also made on the sides of this road. The bridge Jhelum lies at the background of GT Road. It is more than 150 years old. This bridge connects the Lahore to Jhelum. It is a shortcut between the two cities. The bridge was composed of iron trusses over many concrete piers. It has single railway track at one side and the GT Road on the other side of the track. The Grand Trunk Road continues to be one of the major arteries of India and Pakistan. The Indian section is a part of the ambitious Golden Quadrilateral project. For over 4 centuries, the Grand Trunk Road has remained such a river of life as nowhere else exists in the world. Rudyard Kipling had called it a river of life, but for modern driver, it is a nightmare. The 1500 road is full of trucks and rattling buses manned by drivers and without much respect for their lives or yours. One should take care and drive it carefully when driving on GT road.